Hi guys, nice to see you all again. The word of the day is brushes, of course, and this episode is the second part of our small brush tool series. Just as a refresher, last video we talked about how you can edit a brush stroke as a path, how to use the selection pane that hosts your own brushes as well as our presets, and we went in depth on how to customize your brush profile to achieve the exact aesthetic that you want. But what if you want to translate your brush profile to all the other vector paths within our app? Well, you totally can, and that's the exact thing we'll be talking about today. We'll show you how you can use the pen, pencil, and shape tool in more creative ways by switching between a regular path and the brush mode. Much like the pencil tool, brushes are a freehand tool, making them a great pair to start with. Let me show you how you can transform one into another. The great part about our latest update is that you can change a regular pencil path to take the look and feel of a brush profile. All you need to do is select it using the selection tool, and then just tap on this button here inside the Style tab. That's it. And of course, you can change the profile to anything that you created or anything that you find among our presets with just one tap. Also in the Style tab, you can change the stroke of color super easily. Let's just choose some from my color palette here. Furthermore, this regular versus brush mode functionality also works with the pen tool. Let's pick up the pen tool and start off with the brush profile. Then change it to regular after we've created the path, just to switch it up a bit. So now when I'm creating my stroke, it looks like a brush, but it acts like a pen tool. And if we tap on regular, we're back to the same pen path we know and love. And of course, once you're back to regular, you also have access to all these path editing options here. All right, now let's jump into the shape tool. I'm just going to pick the oval shape and draw a regular circle path. Thin our stroke a little bit from the quick actions menu. Okay, and now if we activate the brush mode here, we get this shape which follows the profile of your selected brush. This opens so many possibilities for you to create interesting shapes like these. If I draw a couple more, you can see how much more character they bring to a composition compared to the regular path that we saw before. That's it for today. Thanks so much for watching. Be sure to check out our first episode if you haven't yet. Also, like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you in our next video.